What if homes of the future weren't built brick by brick, but 3D printed layer by layer? For centuries, building a house has followed the same slow rhythm, digging foundations by hand, stacking stones or bricks one by one, a process that takes months, sometimes years. But today, with the housing crisis worsening and costs rising, that kind of time has become a luxury many can't afford. Faster, sometimes cheaper, and even more sustainable, 3D printing is emerging as a serious alternative. But what exactly is a 3D printed house? How does it work? What are the benefits and what comes next? To find out, we spoke with two experts in the field. A 3D printed house is a home built by a 3D printer that lays down concrete layer by layer to form the walls. This concrete is special. It hardens very quickly. Unlike traditional construction with bricks, the machine follows a digital plan and draws the house directly on site. It's a new way of building, more efficient, and one that opens the door to more accessible housing in the future. What are the steps to building a 3D printed house?
So usually the processes, the foundation is pretty much similar to traditional house. There's no changes in there. And instead of cutting wood or stacking bricks or cement units, you use a robotic arm or a gantry to extrude walls. And after that, you have the roof on with traditional way, predominantly using trusses and sometimes concrete slabs. But generally speaking, it's usually single-story or two-story houses been used for so far.
Building a house, whether with 3D printing or traditional methods, generally follows the same steps. First, the foundations are prepared, then the walls are raised, the roof is installed, and finally the finishing touches are done. There are two main types of 3D printers used in construction. Robotic arms are smaller and highly precise, making them ideal for creating complex shapes. They're also mobile, which makes them easy to move around the construction site. On the other hand, the Cartesian 3D printer is larger and more rigid. It can print an entire house in one go. It's less mobile, but well-suited for large-scale projects. The choice depends on the type of house, its complexity, and the time available for the build. What is the most commonly used material for 3D printed houses? The most commonly used material to 3D print a house is a special type of concrete called extrudable concrete. It's fluid enough to be deposited in layers and hardens quickly to build strong walls.
When it comes to construction, the core focus is around concrete. You see a few projects about printing of earth or printing of gypsum, typically, but seems to be less advanced presently.
Unlike traditional concrete, this special concrete has a unique texture. It must be fluid enough to flow easily through the printer's nozzle, but solid enough to hold its shape as soon as it is deposited. This concrete is also adapted depending on the project. According to its intended use, the composition needs to be adjusted.
When you want to develop the ink, you need to understand what is the application that you have, which manufacturing process you will have, and to adapt your ink to this specific application and to the manufacturing process and the construction process as well. And when you have this, then you will define the fresh properties. You want to have something that is robust. You want to print every day in every conditions, that you have a sunny weather or that it's raining, that it's hot or cold. So you need to adjust to that. You have no formworks, so your material will dry from the very beginning with a risk, an enhanced risk of cracking. And you need to make a proper curing of your material to avoid these cracks. And then afterwards, you would like your material to perform as a conventional one.
Sometimes 3D printed concrete is more eco-friendly than traditional concrete because it reduces waste by depositing only the necessary material. But this technology is still developing and improvements are ongoing. Sometimes the concrete mix also needs to be adapted depending on the climate or environment. Can we really print concrete everywhere in all climates?
It's the same thing than with conventional concrete, I would say. You can operate in the usual range of temperatures, and you might have to just adjust slightly your mix depending on your weather conditions, having some recipes for summer conditions and some recipes for winter conditions, but nothing different than with conventional concrete.
What are the advantages of 3D printing homes? This technology offers a real advantage. It can help address the worsening housing crisis. The goal is for 3D printed houses to be accessible to everyone. But the question remains, is it really possible?
In the United States and New Zealand, you can, in Australia, you can buy houses that are 3D printed, but I'm sure in the next couple of years, it will be available. Anyone can buy a house.
There are also other important advantages. 3D printed houses are being built faster and faster, and speed is a real asset. For example, Korox managed to build houses in just 99 days using 3D printing, while traditional construction usually takes about 9 months.
Second thing also is durability, because the material, even though it's, people say it's printed concrete, is actually it's very strong and very durable, and it has a lot lower carbon emissions than traditional concrete. These houses will get cheaper and cheaper over time with the material getting cheaper. Right now, there are a lot of companies says that we're 20% cheaper and stuff like this, but in reality, it is just breaking even or just a little bit cheaper. But the technology did not even reach its full potential. It will, over the next 5 to 10 years, with the scaling up of companies and having more available material and all of the research that's happening with the material, it will come cheaper and cheaper and cheaper, and will be definitely a lot more competitive and cheaper than traditional construction.
For example, in the United States, and more specifically in Texas, houses built using 3D printing cost about 5% less than those made with traditional construction methods. What are the limitations of 3D printed houses? The first major challenge is public perception. Many remain skeptical, seeing it as experimental or futuristic. People question the strength, durability, and comfort of 3D printed homes. Next, global construction standards and sometimes unrealistic expectations must be considered. Many assume faster building means lower costs, which isn't always true. Finally, robotic arms don't replace all trades. Indeed, finishing work and technical installations still need human hands. 3D printing covers a big part of construction, but doesn't replace the entire process. What is the future of 3D printed houses? What are the next steps?
So the biggest step, biggest leaps will be in material availability, and also the cost for the printers will come down, because there's a lot more companies, and a lot of companies are a lot more interested in developing material and supplying material, because they see this market's going to grow and will keep on growing over time. So its accessibility to the technology will be easier. The cost of material will be easier. And also, the systems will be a lot more user-friendly.
3D printing and construction is still developing, but its future looks promising. The next steps focus on improving the quality of materials used, enhancing the durability of structures, and better integrating this technology with existing standards and regulations. So, will the homes of tomorrow be printed instead of built? Let us know what you think in the comments.